Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let's take a look at the new features in macOS Catalina 15.4. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So yesterday, in addition to a new version of iOS, Apple released a new version of macOS as well. This is a major dot release, so with it comes some new features. Let's take a look. So here I am in macOS Catalina version 10.15.4, and the first feature I want to show you is something that's been anticipated since last summer because it was in the beta for Catalina and then it was removed before the final version of Catalina. Now finally it's back. We have shared iCloud folders. So I'm going to go into the Finder here and pick a folder that's already in iCloud Drive. So in this case, my Documents folder is stored in iCloud. So any folder here in my Documents folder will do. Otherwise, if you're not using Documents and Desktop on iCloud, you've got to create a folder or use a folder that's already on your iCloud Drive. You can select that and you can get to the sharing options by control clicking on it and selecting Share and then Add People. You could also click on the Share button here in the toolbar of the Finder and you'll see Add People there as well. Select that and you get the options that you need. So first you have to choose how to share the link to this folder. So you could send an email, send it over messages, AirDrop it, or just copy a link, and that way you could send it any way you want. And I could add some people here, but I don't need to get things going. I can look under Share options here and I could set who can access. So I can say only people I invite or anybody with a link. So if it's only people I invite, I have to enter in Apple IDs up here. Otherwise I can say anyone with a link and then that's not necessary. And then I can do permissions and anybody here can now make changes. They can add files, they can alter the files in there, or view only. So they could just view or download those files. They can't change the files on my iCloud Drive. So anyway, I set this up, I just hit Share and then it will share this folder and it will say Shared by Me right there. If I go back here to Share, you'll see Show People brings the controls up again. And this is how I could turn it off. And this is also how I can change the options. Notice under Share Options I can also copy link if I want. So I can copy and paste or I can send link again using one of these methods. And now you can work on a set of files inside a shared folder with somebody else who also uses iCloud Drive. Another change is a new section under Screen Time. So go into Screen Time and under here you'll see a new section called Communication. You could set limits to contacts only or everyone, or you can have things during downtime only allow communication with specific contacts. This is mostly meant for parental controls, of course, so you can limit who your child can communicate with at various times. Another thing you should be able to do is to set limits on viewing music videos, but I haven't been able to find that control in here yet. And speaking of music, there's a new feature in the Music app. For a while now, iOS and iPadOS have had the ability to show lyrics that advance as the song plays. And now you can do that on the Mac as well. You have to have Apple Music for this, but you can play a song. I have the volume turned down here all the way so I don't get in any trouble. And if I go to View, Show Lyrics, I'll see lyrics pop up here on the right and the lyrics will advance as the song advances. So you see it automatically go to the next line there. Now you can also go and scroll through these lyrics and pick a line and jump to it and it will jump to that part of the song. This also appears in the Mini Player. If I click here to bring up the Mini Player and then I click on the Lyrics button there, I'll see the lyrics here and I could scroll through them. I can click on one and it will jump to that part of the song too. There's a couple new tab tricks in Safari. You now have the ability to duplicate a tab. So if you're at a specific web page and you want to have a second tab open to exactly the same location, you could do it by going to Window, then Duplicate Tab, or Control click on the tab here and choose Duplicate and you get another tab set to the same location. Notice when I Control click here, there's also now a feature to close tabs to the right of the current tab. Another new option is for importing. When you go to File, Import From and say Google Chrome, you now have the option to import passwords from Google Chrome as well. And here's something really cool added under Accessibility. If you go to System Preferences and then go to Accessibility, then you go to Pointer Control, alternate control methods now include Head Pointer. So I'm going to turn that on and then I look under Options. And one of the options there is to choose my camera. So I can choose my webcam here, no problem with that. pointer speed, distance to edge, pointer moves relative to head or when facing screen edges, and some other things. Use a switch to pause or resume, and I can hit OK. And now I can, without my hands, move my cursor using my head. Kind of neat. There are also a few bug fixes and enterprise improvements with this update. You can take a look at the complete list at Apple's site at this page. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.